I'm Donnette Norman, and I'm addressing students in light of the current coronavirus. This is a reality that has caused many of us to be taken out of schools for a while, for a short while, as investigations are done. And also, there is a ban on public functions or public activities such as dance and other things that young people look forward to at this time of the year. Now the fear is real. I've entertained questions and comments such as, will I finish school? What about my exams? What about my career? Really? I haven't even started living yet. I am so fearful. Is this related to God? Is this about the end of the world? What is God saying about this? And so, I've had to go back to the Bible, my source of comfort that has always comforted me over the years. Now, students, if you have been given this time away from school, let me encourage you first. Use it wisely. Get your work done. Do some reading. Balance social media. You should be getting work from your teachers. Ensure that your work is done and properly done. Catch up on some of the exercises in your textbooks that you may have missed. You don't have to get behind, because whether or not Corona continues, if we have exams, you will have to do them when you go back to school, if we go back to school in short order. Also, let me encourage you that you do have a spiritual part of you that needs addressing, because we are more than a body. We have a soul that is accountable to God, and He says that we will have to give an account for how we spend our time. And so if you are a Christian, I want you to consider during this break, have you been a light? Have you been a witness on your campus? Can persons say when they entertain you that they entertain the life of Christ in you? If no, if that is your reality, this is the time to address it. If you are not a Christian, meaning if you do not have the life of Christ, if you have not encountered Christ and have a genuine born-again relationship with Him, now is the time to stop and sort out that aspect of your life. He says in Jeremiah 29 verse 13, and you will seek me and find me when you shall have searched for me with your whole heart. So take some time from this time that you have and seek the Lord. What about you? You have been at school, and guess what? You are a backslider, and your friends, when you look at your circle of friends, they reflect nothing that shows that you even were born in a Christian home or you had an experience with God. You are a backslider. Now is the time to go back to God. Spend some time and read about the prodigal son. God is wanting to restore you during this time. Let me just say to you, students, sin in your heart is worse than cancer, AIDS, coronavirus. God wants to fix it by giving you a new heart, and by you sustaining that heart by feeding on His word daily so you can grow and live. And so let me give you four tips as I close. Number one, put your trust in God, young people. Fear is of the devil. He will cause fear to even paralyze you where you can't even see your way out. Acknowledge God. Number two, take all the precautionary measures that are being given. Stay healthy, eat healthy, practice good hygiene. You need that. Also, be very, very mindful of those around you in your household. Do not be selfish. Think about others. And number four, you, as was said before, be that one in your household that looks out for everyone. It could be your parents who are having a hard time. Don't waste their resources, right? As a member of your family, be an asset in this time. Be helpful. You are at home. Help to do some work. Help tell mommy and daddy to clean up some places that they would have wanted you to clean up. be that child that your parents find as a help in this time when they have added stress. God does not want you to fear. And so I encourage you, use the time you have been given wisely. Be careful too what you watch. What are you watching? What are you listening to? Because if you want God in your life, you have to entertain that which is godly. So I want you to take a stop at the start of your life and see where you are and look up to God and live. Remember, we have a whole lot of resources that can help you to grow in this time. We have 16 editions of Passion and Beauty books where we answer many questions that you have been asking. We want you to get in touch with us and get these books and go through them. They were written for times like this. I remember years ago, in 2008, the Lord showed us that there would come a time when He would require persons to be seeking Him through His Word. And He ordered us. He said, write, begin a movement called Passion and Beauty. Write the books. Put the Word of God in the context where young people live. Answer their issues from the Word of God. Well, we have published those books, and even though we don't have e-copies now, but we have hard copies that you can order and go through them and understand the Word of God and understand what He's saying in relative to your situation. We want you to connect with us. Go to our YouTube channel, Passion and Purity. We also want you to get a hold of our books. Contact us on Instagram, on YouTube, on our Facebook pages. We, Passion and Purity, is saying that God wants you to find your passion and embrace your purity. And He knows how to navigate your life even during times of crisis like this. May God bless you. Stay connected to God. Have a very good day or night.